switch back to English immediately because we have a very special guest, Robert Ross, automotive consultant for Rob Report. Because Rob Report just published a pretty cool list of the most fabulous cars in the world. How are you, Robert?
Well, very well, thank you.
Thank you very much. So, the Rob Report, I understand, has been doing this list for the best cars in the world for 21 years. Is it that correct?
Well, I did with Kurtco for that period of time. We've had Rob Report since 2001, and since about 2003, we've been hosting our Car of the Year event, which essentially gathers the most interesting cars of the new model year, sports and luxury vehicles, and pits them against one another in a very special kind of competition.
Yeah. So for our audience who is not very familiar with Rob Report, can you please tell us exactly what it is? Because this is a very, very exclusive magazine, right? Publication.
Well, Rob Report is available on the newsstand, and it's essentially a magazine that really talks about the best of the best, whether it's automobiles or boats, aircraft, watches, jewelry, wine, travel, all of the various accoutrement of an interesting lifestyle. Of course, cars are always the center of conversation because everybody has to drive, and it seems that everybody likes cars.
And even though most of us, the majority of us, cannot afford some of the cars that are in this particular list, at least we can admire them and learn a little bit more about them, right? And because this technology, eventually, some parts of it will trickle down to cars that we can afford.
Well, that's absolutely right. In fact, you know, some of the days, even the economy cars, least expensive automobiles, outperform just about anything that would have been on the market even 10 years ago. It's an amazing trickle-down theory, as you say.
Yeah, very interesting. So I understand that you have the voting for the 2014 list, and it was held after a pretty special set of test drives, right, out in California.
Yeah, we do this event every year up in Napa at a place called Meadowood. It's a resort, and the nice thing is that we have some great roads locally that allow the judges, all 100 of them this time, to drive the cars on the streets, not on the track, and really evaluate what the automobiles do in a real-world scenario. And of course, the cars range from, you know, why the wildest sports cars to some of the best SUVs and sedans.
Yeah, and you mentioned 100 judges. How is that panel of judges arranged?
Well, most of these judges are actually readers of the magazine. A lot of them are members of the Rob Report Club. A lot of them actually buy their seat at various charity auctions around the country. So, for instance, we've had some people pay as much as $250,000 for an opportunity to join this event.
Wow.
Of course, it's all in the name of charity, so it's a great opportunity for them to donate to some of their favorite causes.
Oh, and that's great. So it just is not because just enjoying the cars, but also trying to do something good for our communities, right?
Yeah, I think you'll find that most of the folks that are involved are pretty philanthropically inclined. Of course, most of them are sufficiently have the resources to actually buy the cars they drive, which is why it's an interesting event. We're actually talking to people who are in a position to buy these cars, and in fact, very many of them go out and order some of the cars that we drive
right after they try them.
Yeah, it's amazing. I think this event probably sells more cars than any single consumer event that I've ever been involved with. It's very gratifying to see them sort of line up. They may want, you know, new Rover anniversary autobiography. They may want Ferraris. This one,
wow.
That one. Everybody ends up walking away with a favorite.
Must be really nice.
So it must be.
Yeah. So can we go a little bit through the list, because and just like maybe focus a little bit on the winner, the Ferrari F12 Berlinetta, because not only it won the voting this year, but I understand it was an anonymous vote.
Well, it was really amazing. I mean, this is, in all my years of doing this and in gathering cars as diverse as, you know, Ferraris, Lamborghinis, Bentleys, Rolls Royces, all kinds of cars, this is the year that the car that was the winner, the Ferrari F12 Berlinetta, absolutely took a landslide decision. There were a few dissenters. Some of the folks preferred maybe the Audi R8 V10, and a couple of them maybe the Lamborghini Aventador or an Aston Martin Vanquish Volante. But overall, the Ferrari got more votes, hands down, by a landslide. The car just proved to be remarkable. It delivered on just about everything.
Yeah, the Ferrari F2 Barinetta has a V12 engine with 731 horsepower, 0 to 60 in 3.1 seconds, and top speed of 211 miles per hour. I mean, like, just really an amazing car. I mean, everything that Ferrari does pretty much is, I guess, it's been always on this kind of voting for Rob Report, right?
Well, Ferraris have always come out as near the top of the list. And really what makes this car so remarkable is that even though, you know, you mentioned the horsepower and the top speed and the acceleration, those things are great. But there are other cars that do that. What the Ferrari does, what this car does, is put it all together in a package that's so complete, so easy to drive, so responsive, almost to your every thought. You would think that this thing is hooked directly up to your brain.
Yeah.
It's an amazing achievement.
Yeah.
And it's comfortable, too.
Exactly. And not only that, but Ferrari is one of the few manufacturers that can really export or, like, trickle down, as we were saying before, the technology from Formula One to these kind of cars, right?
That's right. Their racing experience really plays a big role in allowing them to engineer this car to respond in a way that really sets the standard for sports cars.
Yeah. Some of the others that you mentioned, some of the others cars that were in competition.
Well, coming in second place was the Audi R8 V10 Plus, which is a remarkable mid-engine coupe that has been on the market for a while, but every year Audi has been able to improve it to some extent. And really, at about $200,000, it represents the pinnacle of sports car design and engineering and manufacture. It's really a beautiful car. And right under that came the most audacious exotic, which was the Lamborghini Aventador Roadster.
Yeah.
That thing looks like a spaceship, truly from outer space.
Yeah.
Everyone loved it. It was the coupe version was our car of the year a couple of years ago, but a very single-purpose car, certainly.
Yeah. Lamborghini actually did the global launch for that car last year here in Miami. And they closed down the runway at the airport.
So, oh, man alive.
We were driving those cars there. Like, it was just an amazing, amazing event. So, Robert, just like just in due of time, because obviously this is radio and we have a limited time. So the Aston Martin Vanquish Volante, the BMW M6 Grand Coupe, the Bentley Flying Spur, the Porsche Cayman S, like, talking about, like, very expensive cars, this car is actually kind of affordable. It's kind of like 60, starts around 65, I understand. Maybe a little bit
it
more.
It was. Ours was loaded to the tune of about $100,000. It was certainly fully optioned, but we got that in there because we wanted to really explore what happens when you get into that almost the affordable stratosphere.
Yeah.
It came and acquitted itself. It had a lot of fans.
Yeah, Porsche actually is famous for that. I mean, I had the privilege last week to go and drive the 918 Spyder, the super hybrid plug-in hard in a Circuit of the Americas in Austin, Texas, and that car starts at $845,000, and there's an option, a performance option, it's about $95,000,
which is more than a Cayman,
which is the price of the
more than the Cayman.
Yeah, the 911. I mean, but it's like a fascinating world just to, like, be a little bit in touch with that. So pretty fascinating. So another Porsche car in your list, the Porsche Panamera Turbo, and then Jaguar, the F-Type, which has been winning a lot of awards everywhere around the world, right?
That's right. That's right. Certainly look to them to do some interesting things in terms of safety engineering and really advancing that state of the art.
The Corvette Stingray, the new Corvette, which is been fantastic and also winning a lot of things. The Mercedes-Benz S-Class, the Maserati Quattroporte. Maserati is coming along really nicely lately. Then the Land Rover Range Rover Autobiography Edition. And then the Viper, which is also came back with a nice new edition, much, much improved from the previous one.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. A lot of cars with a lot of different attributes. So, all of them worth driving.
Excellent. So, Robert, can you please share, like, where our audience can, again, maybe not go and buy one, but, like, maybe enjoy your report? Where can they go online, I guess, or maybe buy the magazine?
Sure. Absolutely. The magazine is actually the April 2014 edition of Rob Report. It is available on the newsstand. And if someone wants to just have a little bit of a glance, go to robreport.com. and have some fun sorting through all the great things on the site.
Yeah, Robert Rose, automotive consultant for Rob Report. And Robert, so the 2015 edition, when will those cars are going to be tested by these privileged people who do your event?
Well, we're going to do it in November of this year and then publish it in April of 2015. And as you'd mentioned, that great Porsche 918, I hope to have that there this year, along with some other cars that really, really set the bar.
Exactly. I'm sure it's going to be there, and I'm sure it's going to be do well in your voting, too, because it's a fantastic car.
Well, can't wait to try it.
Thank you very much, Robert, and we'll hopefully maybe make a trip to California in November.
Well, I would love to meet up, and I certainly appreciate the hospitality and the opportunity to meet some of your listeners.
Thank you very much.
A great pleasure. Take care.
Bye.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.